Hi, this is Asing. You are now watching Asing Math TV. Today, I would like to share how to obtain the Maclaurin series of log 1 plus sine x. When we differentiate log 1 plus sine x to the base 10, we should obtain 1 over 1 plus sine x times ln 10. When we differentiate sine x, we obtain cos x. If let's say we don't like to apply product rule or quotient rule for this complicated function, we can let fx be equal to the numerator cos x and gx be equal to 1 plus sine x. We can ignore ln 10 since ln 10 is constant, and we just have to expand both the functions fx and gx. At point x equal to 0, cos 0 is equal to 1. While g0 is equal to 1 plus 0, also 1. Differentiate f with respect to x, we obtain negative sine x. At point 0, we obtain 0. Differentiate g with respect to x, we obtain cos x. At point 0, we obtain 1. Differentiate further, we obtain negative cos, and we should obtain negative 1 at point 0. And for function g, we have negative sine x, and we should obtain 0. And next, we have differentiate cos is negative sign. So negative, negative, positive. And for function g, we differentiate for the third time. Differentiate sign is cos. So we should obtain negative 1. Since we have obtained 3 non-zero terms for the function g, but only 2 non-zero terms for the function f. So I'm going to differentiate the function f for one more time. When we differentiate sine, we obtain cos, which means that at the point 0, we have 1. Now we can form the Maclaurin series for both the functions. For function f, we have 1. This is the original function, so over 0 factorial, 1 over 1 is equal to 1. And we plus second derivative, negative 1 over 2 factorial, x to the power of 2, plus fourth derivative, 1 over 4 factorial, x to the power of 4, and so on. And for the function g, we have 1 plus first derivative, 1 over 1 factorial x to the power of 1, and we plus third derivative negative 1 over 3 factorial x to the power of 3, and so on. Let's simplify. So we have 1 plus minus minus 1 over 2 x to the power of 2 plus 1 over 4 factorial is 24 x to the power of 4. And function g, we have 1 plus x minus 1 over 6x cubed, and so on. Since what we need here is cos x over 1 plus sine x, to obtain the series expansion of this, we just have to apply log division. So which means that we should have 1 plus 0x minus 1 over 2x squared plus 0x cubed plus 1 over 24x power 4 plus so on divided by the function g, which is 1 plus sine x. And we have the expansion 1 plus x minus 1 over 6x cubed. And the rule of thumb of applying log division is always reduce the first term to 0. In order to obtain 0, we should minus exactly the same term, which is 1. In order to have 1, we need to times 1. So 1 times 1 is equal to 1. When we minus, we obtain 0. And for the second term, 1 times 1x. So we have 1x. 1 times negative 1 over 6x cubed, we have negative 1 over 6x cubed. When we apply law of division, always first line minus second line. 1 minus 1, 0. 0 minus 1 minus 1x. Minus 1 over 2x squared. 0 minus negative become positive. 1 over 6x cubed. And plus 1 over 24x to the power 4, and so on. Next, to reduce negative x to 0, again, we should minus exactly the same term, which means that we should times negative x. Minus x times 1 minus x. Minus plus minus. X times x, x squared. Minus minus plus 1 over 6 x, x cubed, x to the power 4, and so on. And we just have to apply subtraction here. So we have negative 1 over 2 minus negative 1. And we should obtain 1 over 2 plus 1 over 6 x cubed. Next, we should have 1 over 24 minus 1 over 6, and we obtain negative 1 over 8 x to the power 4. Continue, we should have plus 1 over 2 x squared plus 1 over 2 x squared plus 1 over 2 x cubed. X squared times x to the power 3, we should have x to the power 5. But what we want here is up to x to the power 4. So we can ignore. And we just have to add 3 dots. When we minus, we should have 1 over 6 minus 1 over 2. We obtain negative 1 over 3x cubed minus 1 over 8x to the power 4. So which means that we should have negative 1 over 3x cubed, negative 1 over 3x cubed, negative, positive, negative, 1 over 3x to the power of 4, and so on. And we minus again, we should obtain negative 1 over 8 minus negative 1 over 3, and we obtain 5 over 24 x to the power of 4, and so on. The last term that we should have is plus 5 over 24 x to the power of 4, and so on. Recall that when we differentiate log 1 plus sine x to the base 10 is equal to cos x over 1 plus sine x times ln 10, which is equal to 1 over ln 10 times 1 minus x plus 1 over 2x squared minus 1 over 3x cubed plus 5 over 24x to the power 4, and so on. To obtain log 1 plus sine x to the base 10, we just need to integrate both sides with respect to x. Integrate, differentiate, cancel each other. Differentiate x, cancel, differentiate x. Left hand side, left log 1 plus sine x to the base 10. And this is equal to, since this is constant, when we integrate, we can take out. When we integrate 1, we obtain x. Minus, when we integrate power plus 1 over power plus 1. Plus 1 over 2 power plus 1 over power plus 1. minus 1 over 3 power plus 1 over power plus 1 plus 5 over 24 x to the power of power plus 1 over power plus 1 and so on. So this is equal to 1 over ln 10 times x minus 1 over 2x squared plus 1 over 6x cubed minus 1 over 12x to the power 4 plus 1 over 24x to the power 5 and so on. And we already obtained the Maclaurin series of log 1 plus sine x to the base 10 and hence with that. Okay, that's all for this video. Thanks for watching. Hope you like this. See you.